Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. Welcome to another Shopify tutorial video. In this tutorial, I'll show you guys how you can add 3D slider for your product and your collection. After watching this tutorial, you will have a 3D product or collection slider, which will look something like this. So when I scroll down, it's gonna show me the next product or collection, depends on what you wanna display. And when you take your mouse over it, you can click and go to that product as well. So I created a last video related to 3D image slider where in this section, it was only allowed to add images. But after getting some feedback from my team and from your comments, I was able to update that. So it's basically the version 2 of 3D slider, which also supports product and collection. It's really simple to add. I'm gonna share step-by-step instruction on how you can do that on your Shopify very easily, which will improve the layout of your Shopify store. If you are new to this channel, I have created more than 200 tutorials, around 200 tutorials related to optimizing the UI of your Shopify store, helping you adding features which can boost sales as well. So if you are new to this channel, make sure to subscribe this channel. It will give you a lot of free knowledge. So make sure to subscribe because it's free. Okay, so let's proceed with adding this section, right? And this is my development store. Before moving on to this, let's review some of the old section which I have created in this YouTube channel. So here's another slider which I have created. This is not available by default. You can get this in link in the description, or you can subscribe to check my other videos. So these are all different types of sliders which I have created. Okay, and then we have this reel slider where you can add your Instagram reels, YouTube shorts, and vertical videos if you have any. These are the vertical tabs. Here's the before after slider, really good for the stores which are selling cosmetics products or skincare products. Really important to have that. This is the lookbook section and multiple other sections which I have created. You can see there are a lot of sections. Again, I don't want to go over everything, but you will find all of the links in the description, or you can subscribe to this channel. Now let me go to the back end of the store and show you guys that what other features you will be getting on this 3D product and collection slider, right? So let me take you to the customize settings where I already have the section installed. So I'm gonna go to online store and then click on customize. And on the home page, I already have that section. Okay, so scrolling down, and here it is, 3D gallery. And here you have the option of that how many scroll per item you want and what is the distance you want. So there is a distance in between each slide, right? Or each transition. You can increase the distance by these settings here. And this section currently looks vertical on the mobile version. So if I switch to the mobile version, it's going to display the products or collection in a stacked format, just like this. So if you don't want this section to be displayed on the mobile version, you can simply hide section on mobile from these settings here. Right now, if I go to any of the gallery, so I have these three gallery items. If I click any of them, here you can see we have the option of image, product, and collection. Currently, I have selected it product and selected my product. Let's switch to collection. And now I'm going to select my collection. I only have one collection, so I'm going to select that and hit save. And you can see that now my collection is being displayed, right? Again, I can switch to product and I can switch to image only. I'll just click on select and select my appropriate image to display here, right? Here we have the option to hide or display the product name. So here you can see that all products are showing up. I can hide it from desktop. And if you want a separate customization for mobile version, you can do that as well. So if you hide it from mobile and desktop and then click save, it's not going to display the name for this slide or for this gallery item. You can see it's not showing up. we have the option of enabling and disabling the button. So if I enable the button and click save, I'll have the button which will also be clickable and which will have this text here, view details, right? And it's being displayed on Hoover. By the way, guys, I can add a lot more features on this section. So I just want 100 likes from you guys on this video. If you give me 100 likes to this video, I'm gonna add whatever settings you request in the comment. Settings could be changing the button radius, changing the button color, changing the button background color, changing the button font color. There are multiple settings which I can add, adding the custom font feature. So there are a lot of features which I have already created on other sections. I can create on that section as well. Just the 100 likes and the list in the comments to make me create this updated version for you guys. Okay guys, similarly, we have this second gallery item and we can add multiple gallery items. So I have just added multiple items and I am going to select the images to show you guys how it's going to look with more images. Okay. Three more images to go. Perfect. One more left. Okay, click on done and then click save. Perfect. I'm gonna visit that on my homepage and hit refresh. Scroll down to the bottom and here you can see I have multiple images. And it just not also only displays the image on this part here, it also changed the background as per the image of that specific item, right? So you can see it's also on the background, scaled and blurred to make it look awesome. Looks good, right? You scroll up, it's gonna go back in the reversal mode. Scroll down, it's gonna go forward. Okay, now without further ado, let's get into it and let me show you guys how I can install that really easily on a fresh theme. So I have always created tutorial with a Dawn theme and I've also used Sense theme. So this time what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna install a refresh theme and I'm gonna show you guys how this section will look on the refresh theme. So let's click on add button. And our refresh theme is being installed, guys. While this is being installed, there's a link in the description. If you sign up through that link, you will get your Shopify store for just $1 a month. Yes, you heard me right. It's just for $1 a month. You don't have to pay $29, $30 for the monthly subscription. You will be signing up for the Shopify store for just $1 a month if you use the link in the description. And this is a limited time offer, so make sure to avail that. Okay, guys, our refresh theme has been installed and now I'm gonna click on publish. And then click on publish again. Perfect, our theme has been published. Let's preview that. Click on these three small dots and then click on preview. I'm going to close the older tab. And if I scroll down, you can see that's how our refresh theme looks like. And this is the blog post where you will find the code which we will be using in this video. This is completely free. You don't have to sign up for any newsletter or anything like that. The link in the description, just click on it and click on copy code button to copy all of the codes, right? Okay, now let's add it on a refresh theme. Click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. By the way, this section should work completely fine on all of the paid theme as well, not just the free theme. So if you're having any issues, if the section is not working properly on your paid theme, let me know in the comments below. I'll definitely help you guys completely for free. Okay, theme.liquid. Oops, sorry, not the theme.liquid. I'm going to create a new section file. And for that, let's click on this arrow and then click on add a new section. I'm gonna name this 3D gallery. Perfect, click on done. And now remove all of the existing code which is present. So I'm just gonna remove that code. And from the link in the description, which you will guys will find, click on this copy code and then paste the code. Great. After pasting the code, click on save. And now let's click on these three small dots and then open the theme customizer by clicking on customize theme. And from here, we will add our new section which we just created. So go to sections, and from here, click on art section here, and then you will find it here. You can also search it by 3D gallery. So that's the name of the section. And once you add the section, you'll be able to add the gallery items, the gallery image. Okay, let me add images and show you guys how it's gonna look. Again, you can select the product and collection as well, and those product or collection will be clickable. So whoever is visiting this gallery will be able to click and reach to that product. Okay, second image is added. Let's add in the third image. And here you go. The third image is added. Click on save. And now I'm going to my refresh theme and hit refresh. That's it. Okay. Scroll down to the bottom and here you can see our 3D image slider looks awesome. Looks cool, right? So that's it for the video, guys. Let me know in the comments below if you guys would like me to add more features to this tutorial. Just 100 likes, not a biggie. So make sure to hit that like button. Until next video, have a great day.